When you figure out who you are, you cease to become vulnerable to influences outside of God. But as long as you are vulnerable in the area of your identity, you become susceptible to every attack of the enemy. Do you know that when Jesus was in the wilderness being tempted by the devil, he said, if you are the Son of God, turn these rocks into bread. What is that? It's a challenge of his identity. And it was right on the heels of him being baptized when God the Father tore open the heavens and said, this is my beloved Son. Do you know the same's true over your life? The devil will attack you in the area of your identity. You were not created to stand back and watch other people do exceptional things. You see, the lies that we bought into, even as Christians, is this, is that there's just a few people that do really exceptional things. The rest of us, the best that we can hope for is to get through life with the least amount of resistance or experience the least amount of pain. Most of us, we kind of grow up thinking, well, don't get your hopes up too high. You're probably gonna experience a lot of disappointment. You're gonna be average at best. You're gonna be like a snowflake. You're unique, but nobody's gonna know when you land. But that's not at all how God sees you. And it's not at all how God created you, especially recreated you in Christ Jesus. He's created you, Ephesians 2:10 says, for good works that he prepared beforehand that you should walk in them. Do you know that in Jesus Christ, you're seated with Christ in heavenly places? You've been made brand new. You are a vessel of clay, but you contain the Spirit of the living God. You have a destiny that predates your personhood. You were in the mind of God long before you ever had a name. And when you were saved, when you were born again, he began to unleash. There's stuff on the inside of you that he wants to come out. But as long as we believe the lies that we can never do anything other than just hold on and make it to heaven, we will live so far below our birthright. Church, we need to know that we were created to flourish in Jesus.